Thank you, Leslie. Abraham Lincoln said, and I quote, "I am a firm believer in the people. If given the truth, they can be depended upon to meet any national crisis. The great point is to bring them the real facts." End of quote. We have been bringing you the facts based on the evolving science of this pandemic for over a year now. I am very happy that the people of this blessed federation have listened to the facts about the virus and have acted. First, in the all of society involvement in containing the deadly virus with the prescription of non-pharmaceuticals. When the vaccines arrived, you listened as we launched an extensive education program and then began to come in, rolling up your sleeves to be vaccinated. You did this not just to protect yourself, but also to protect those who cannot be vaccinated. I am very happy that as of yesterday, 55.8% of adults over the age of 18 did the right thing and received their first shot. And 21% of adults over the age of 18 are now fully vaccinated. These numbers will continue to climb as more and more persons are following the facts and science and coming forward voluntarily and getting vaccinated. I want to urge everyone to continue to remain focused, continue to educate yourself, continue to protect yourself and your loved ones, and we will get through this together. The recent cluster of COVID-19 cases we're experiencing is our first, and it served as a wake-up call for many. I want to let you know, however, that it will not be our last. As long as the virus remains circulating globally, it will keep coming once our borders are open. We are going to have to learn to live with COVID-19 for some time, but make sure we are protected, especially from severe disease and death through vaccination. We can also help to decrease the spread of COVID-19, as the science is now showing that you have a 63 to 83% risk reduction of contracting COVID-19 through vaccination. We need to continue to prepare for this attack and the next by having as many persons over the age of 18 vaccinated. Let us continue to protect ourselves and our school children and the elderly and frail. So many parents have called me, some in tears and fearful as the current situation with the cluster involving school children and adults unfolds. We will continue to keep in your prayers, but you can be assured that based on the history of this virus, all the children should recover and do well. As adults, you can protect yourself by getting vaccinated, along with the continued use of the non-pharmaceuticals that kept us safe over the past year. The results returned yesterday from testing was great news, as of the more than 570 persons with significant contacts tested, all 570 plus tests were negative. These results point towards containment of the virus. We will continue to widen the web of contact tracing to encircle and contain this deadly virus. We should expect to get more positive results, meaning finding more positive COVID-19 cases as we continue our contact tracing exercise. We will have a clearer picture of where we are 14 days out from the start of this cluster. We will continue to do all in our power to break the chain of transmission and get a cap on this spread very soon. Some persons have been expressing concerns re the dosing interval for the vaccine being administered, as we were using a dosing interval of 10 weeks, but have now readjusted this for some. And there are a few points you need to know about the vaccine and the vaccine doses. The vaccine is given in two doses. The minimum interval is actually 28 days. The dosing interval recommended by the manufacturer is 4 to 12 weeks. The World Health Organization recommend its use between 8 and 12 weeks. The efficacy after the first dose is 76%. The efficacy climbs slowly up to 82.4% after the second dose. The longer the dosing interval, is associated with a higher efficacy. And the highest efficacy is seen when it's given 10 to 12 weeks after the first dose. There is, however, absolutely no health risk to persons having a shorter dosing interval, that is between 4 and 10 weeks. Many countries throw an interval of 8 to 12 weeks. We chose 10 weeks initially. To increase the number of persons benefiting from the first dose, with vaccine shortage globally, some countries have even extended their interval to 16 weeks to ensure that as many persons as possible get one shot. In countries at risk of having these life-saving vaccines expire, they have shortened the dosing interval, but not below 4 weeks, to make sure that all persons who got their first shot get fully vaccinated. In a pandemic with a deadly virus, having 76% protection from just one jab is better than no protection at all. Again, we have reached too far in this fight to lose the gains we have made. A lot of us have been working around the clock to keep you safe. We will continue in this fight. Let us continue to work together and not get complacent. And this, of course, requires your assistance. We need the assistance of everyone. And so I ask you again, go out and get vaccinated. Continue to wear your mask, hand sanitizer, and social distance, and avoid mass gatherings. We will get through this together. I know the weekend is coming up when persons tend to go out and party and fet. I ask you to do the right thing this weekend and try and avoid mass gatherings so we can contain the spread. I thank you.